So there have been lots of rumors and supposed leaks flying around the coaster community for literally years now, claiming that Cedar Point was going to remove Wicked Twister, and I kind of became numb to it, to the point that when Cedar Point posted this video on their YouTube channel today, officially announcing the closure of Wicked Twister, I was pretty caught off guard, and I'm kind of upset, to be completely honest. There was some dramatic music and some cheesy sound effects that went along with this closure announcement that Cedar Point posted earlier today. Again, if you want to watch the whole thing, get the whole experience, you can go watch on Cedar Point's YouTube channel. They have this video up, and I'm just not happy about this one bit. Some people have already started like trying to pull clues out of this closure announcement video as to what Cedar Point's going to be doing next, but I think just the fact that Wicked Twister's closing is about all there is to pull out of this video. I think pulling anything else out of it would just be a little bit of overanalysis. There are people already talking about they might bring Mantis back because she was looking at Mantis in the book. That's just stupid. They're not going to do that, guys. Just the whole point of this video is that Wicked Twister is going to be gone. September 6th, 2021 is Wicked Twister's official final operating day, which is only a month away. I wish Cedar Point would give us a little bit more time, so if anyone wanted to travel and get their last rides on this thing, they could a little bit easier, because 1 month is pretty last minute, but I think it's safe to say I wasn't going to be able to get out there anyway. I will forever have never ridden Wicked Twister. Very sad. But if you do have money in your budget and time on your schedule to make a last minute trip out to Cedar Point in the next month to bid Wicked Twister farewell, get your first and last rides ever if you've never ridden it before, or just, you know, get one last ride if it's one of your favorites and you're sad to see it go, you have about a month to do that. I also should mention Cedar Point is actually having some kind of special event on the ride's closing day. They haven't given the details of that yet, but if you are planning a trip out to bid it farewell, you may want to see if you can have that trip extend over its official closing day, because there'll be some kind of festivities involved with that. Well, as festive as a ride closing can be. This is just another victim in a chain of coasters that I have seen in person but never gotten to ride, closing forever and securing my fate of having never ridden them. It all started with Dragon Challenge at Islands of Adventure. I saw that ride, but that was before I had really, you know, gotten over my fear of roller coasters, so I didn't ride it. And now I never will, because it's gone, obviously. At King's Island, I literally stood in the Firehawk queue for almost 20 minutes before deciding the line wasn't worth it and I would just catch it next time I came. That didn't happen because it closed at the end of the summer. And then Vortex was another ride at King's Island I did not ride while I was there, but I was hoping to get on when I get back to King's Island because it's such a classic ride. But that ride's gone too now. So, and then Wicked Twister is another one. Obviously, y'all saw I have the Cedar Point vlog up on my channel. If you didn't see it, I wasn't there for very long, so I had to prioritize which rides I wanted to ride, and unfortunately Wicked Twister just didn't make my agenda this time around. But I was really looking forward to this ride when I came back to Cedar Point, and it's sad to know that now I won't ever get to ride it. Aside from that, this ride being removed is really going to change, I think, the Cedar Point experience more than people realize. First of all, just the skyline. This is even mentioned in the blog post where they talked about this ride closure as well, how when it was built it drastically changed the Cedar Point skyline, and I feel like not enough people are noticing that. Right now you have these giant 215 foot tall yellow spirals that I think are really a defining characteristic of Cedar Point's skyline. I was just looking through Cedar Point's website, and like half the pictures on their website, you can see Wicked Twister is very distinctly there in the pictures of Cedar Point. And so I think it's really going to change the look of Cedar Point a lot more than people realize, just to not have the structure there to begin with. I know some people that watch this channel are not super up on their coaster knowledge, so I guess I should explain before we move further. Wicked Twister is an inverted shuttle coaster at Cedar Point in Sandusky, Ohio. Inverted meaning that you sit hanging below the track with your feet dangling, and shuttle coaster meaning that you travel both forwards and backwards, kind of covering the same section of track, in this case over and over again. It features an electromagnetic launch that, from what I hear, is pretty powerful, and I think you go back and forth about 5 times, I believe, was the number that they gave. This ride opened in 2002, so it's been at Cedar Point for nearly 20 years now, but of course it's never going to hit its 20-year birth date, because it's going to be gone just shy of it The thing is, simply because Cedar Point has so many other just world-renowned attractions, Wicked Twister isn't really a huge standout for the park, which means that it's also not a huge draw for people to come to the park, so Cedar Point isn't really going to lose anything in terms of, you know, guest visitor numbers, etc., etc., people coming to the park. This isn't really going to change that much, if any, at all. So it's not really a bad business decision, but I still do think Cedar Point is going to be missing some things in their coaster lineup now that they've removed this coaster. Because the beautiful thing about impulse coasters, which is the brand name given to this type of coaster by its manufacturer Intamin, is that it manages to be both a launch inverted coaster and a launch shuttle coaster. And there are not very many launch inverted coasters in the world, and there are not very many inverted shuttle coasters in the world. So this manages to pack two different levels of uniqueness into one ride, which happened to be two things that Cedar Point does not have elsewhere. By removing this ride, they will no longer have a launched inverted coaster or a inverted shuttle coaster at the park. In my opinion, the inverted launch coaster is the bigger deal out of those two, because while I've never experienced a launch in an inverted coaster before, I have heard from a few people that have that it is really a truly unique experience. Like, something about launching while hanging below the track just feels a lot different than a standard sit-down launch. So I really think Cedar Point will be missing something that they had before by removing this ride, just from losing that unique type of launch experience. Of course, they have two other launch coasters, Maverick and Top Thrill Dragster, so it's not like they'll be missing launches particularly, especially since Dragster has one of the most notoriously intense launches in the world, but they will be missing that, you know, suspended below the track acceleration feeling that, you know, neither Maverick nor Dragster have. If Cedar Point was just removing a ride to make space for a new ride, which is something they have to do now, they're kind of out of space, it was either going to be this or Ruguru. This and Ruguru are kind of the only two coasters that I think, at least two major coasters at Cedar Point, would be able to remove without much fuss. But I almost would have rather than remove Ruguru, because, I mean, you can get a steel sit-down looping coaster at pretty much any other amusement park on the planet, any major amusement park anyway, but Wicked Twister was just a truly unique ride. It's something that you can't ride everywhere. You can ride something like Ruguru pretty much anywhere. You can't ride something like Wicked Twister at most amusement parks. At the same time, I don't think it was going to be Ruguru this time anyway. I don't think that was even on the table, because I don't personally think that the removal of Wicked Twister had anything to do with making space for a future ride or attraction of any kind. I think it was solely due to maintenance costs. Roller coasters built by Intamin like this one are notoriously difficult and expensive to maintain, and as I mentioned earlier in this video, Wicked Twister just does not draw crowds like a lot of Cedar Point's other coasters do. This is not a coaster that draws a significant number of people to the park, so it may have just hit the point where the amount that it was costing Cedar Point to keep this thing running was just not worth it for what it was doing for the park. At the end of the day, it's a business. Cedar Point stated that the reason for this ride's removal was that they wanted to make space for exciting new experiences or something like that, but anyone that's been paying attention to the amusement park industry for a while knows that when a park gives a reason for an attraction's removal, it's usually a bunch of horse crap. If Wicked Twister is not a major draw for people to visit the park, and they can remove it without much fuss, then why would they keep paying to maintain it? It's my personal theory that they just kind of hit that point, and I think that's the main reason why Wicked Twister is leaving Cedar Point after this season. Talking about what could possibly replace Wicked Twister, as you can see, I don't think it's going to be a new roller coaster, just because look at the plot of land it's on. It is a very small plot of land that is about the biggest roller coaster you're going to be able to fit on this land, and it is pretty much landlocked in this little parcel. By, you have Gatekeeper to the south there, which obviously that ride's not going anywhere. You have the freaking ocean to the east, obviously that's not going anywhere either. You do have some smaller flat rides to the left, but of course one of those is their Ferris wheel, and I just don't see them removing their Ferris wheel just to make room for a Wicked Twister roller coaster replacement, because that still wouldn't really free up enough space to build a record-breaking coaster like Cedar Point's known for. I just don't see them removing their Ferris wheel for a small-scale roller coaster on this plot of land. You do have a stadium to the north there, or some kind of a venue, I don't exactly know what that is, that could possibly be removed to kind of make space on this, like, candy cane-shaped plot of land for, again, just a small-scale roller coaster, but I just don't really think that's the move. In all honesty, I think this land will probably end up being used for some kind of new, you know, restaurant, or maybe just a relax and look out on Lake Erie type area, or something not as exciting along those lines. I mean, he did say, park improvements, not our next exciting giant attraction. So if anything, it's just going to be something small and probably kind of anticlimactic considering what used to be there. What would be really cool that they're definitely not going to do, but if they just removed kind of the queue line and all the rides' mechanical systems and just, left the track there since it's such an iconic part of Cedar Point's skyline, then you don't really change the skyline and you can kind of make it kind of this like sculpture thing that people can, walk under and just see the track. I don't know. That would be cool. And maybe have like a tribute to Wicked Twister under there. That's what I would most prefer they do with this land, but I really don't think that's what they're going to do because I really do think this ride is going to get relocated. So now that we've talked about the future of the parcel of land at Cedar Point, we can talk about the future of the ride itself because I don't think it's going to be scrapped, as I just said. I know that may be wishful thinking considering Cedar Fair's recent track record with, closed rides. Both Vortex and Firehawk at Kings Island both got scrapped. Those were their two most recent closures. Knott's Berry Farm's Boomerang got sold to some park overseas. Stinger at Dorney Park, presumably scrapped. We don't really know. Definitely not at another Cedar Fair park, though. They really haven't done a ride relocation in a long time. Everything's either been sold overseas or scrapped. So people are making the reasonable assumption that Wicked Twister is either going to be sold overseas or scrapped. But I feel like it's going to be making its way to another Cedar Fair park. I heard rumblings recently, and I don't remember where or if it was in any way a reputable source, but I did hear rumblings that an Intamin Impulse Coaster was in California Great America's, possible 5-year plan, and that would make sense. What if Wicked Twister was going to California's Great America? I could see it. California's Great America lacks any kind of major launch coaster at the moment. In fact, I don't think they have any kind of launching roller coaster at all. So this would fit that gap while giving them something, decently unique that people might actually travel for, especially Cedar Point fans that want to take another ride on what used to be Wicked Twister will make their way out to California to ride whatever this ends up being called at CGA. CGA just seems like an ideal choice in my opinion. Cedar Fair has made it obvious that they want to make investments in California's Great America and they want to grow it as a park, but not at the rate that they want to grow something like Cedar Point or Carowinds. It's one of their more mid-tier parks, and this is like the perfect addition that says, we want to invest and put some care into you. We don't want to give you the craziest thing on the planet, so here, take this. This is pretty dang good, and this will satisfy most people. Like, this is just that perfect type of ride. So while California's Great America makes the most sense to me, I could see this really being relocated to any of the smaller Cedar Fair parks. I don't think a park like Kings Island or Carowinds needs this, or even King's Dominion. I think this will be going to, a smaller Cedar Fair park, like Worlds of Fun or Michigan's Adventure or something. It seems crazy to think of them making any kind of major investment in a park like Michigan's Adventure, but I mean, if you already have the ride, can't cost that much to install? Question mark. Dorney Park and Valley Fair, two of Cedar Fair's other smaller parks, both already have Intamin Impulse coasters very similar to this, so why not go ahead and keep the trend going and every smaller Cedar Fair park gets an Impulse coaster. But even if Wicked Twister does find new life at a new Cedar Fair park, it still won't be exactly the same ride experience. As you can see from the POV video here, it is literally built right on the side of the beach on Lake Erie, which really gives it the feel of being like a boardwalk coaster, but it's way bigger than any boardwalk would be willing to build a coaster. So it's really a unique ride experience just in that way, just being able to see the beach and Lake Erie while you launch. I just don't think that could be replicated in any other location. I feel like wherever this ends up going, if it doesn't get scrapped, it's just not going to hold up. Now you may be asking, if you think this ride's being removed due to maintenance costs, why would they relocate it? Wouldn't it just be moving the maintenance costs to one of their other parks? And yes, that is true, but maintenance costs are relative to an extent. While it may not be worth it for Cedar Fair to continue maintaining and operating this ride, at a smaller park, this ride could really be the star of the show, or at least significantly add to the park's overall experience to the point that it really increases the number of guests who want to keep visiting over and over again, and therefore increase profits. So at another park, even if maintenance costs are exactly the same, it could be much more worth it to a smaller park where this ride would actually be drawing a lot of crowds and increasing their overall business and revenue. Alright, and for better or for worse, that's about all I have to say about Wicked Twister's removal, for now at least. I'm very, very sad to see it go. I'm very, very sad that I'll never get to ride this while it's at Cedar Point, but hopefully it finds new life at a new Cedar Fair park soon, and I can experience it there at some point, and if it doesn't, hopefully I'll still be able to get on another Impulse Coaster at some point in my coaster enthusiast life and get a similar ride experience. But be sure to let me know down in the comments below what your thoughts are on Wicked Twister's removal. Do you think it's a good or bad idea? Do you think it's going to end up in another park, or do you think it's going to get scrapped? And what do you think will replace it at Cedar Point, and kind of what is Cedar Point's future plan going forward? I'd love to read you guys' thoughts. I always like reading thoughts when you guys put them down there, and I do read and respond to pretty much all my comments. So keep the conversation going, and I'll see you next time.